born a woman, you will die a woman. It doesn't matter how much exchange. It doesn't matter how much your cousin beats and your cousin loves. If you're born a man, you die a man. A man cannot be present to your son. When a man passes, you must be a man passed. Doesn't matter how much exchange. He exchanged. When a woman passes, it doesn't matter how much you say that she's a man. She smells like a woman too. Because God did not make a mistake. He did not make Adam and Eve. And the garden of Eden, he made Adam and Eve. God created man to dominate over the animals. No man was taken, a human being, man was taken a dog and loved a dog more than he loved a human being. Something wrong in this country, America. America lost the dignity. America lost the pride. America lost the God. America was one nation under one God. America was the leading nation all over the world. Now America changed and saying that the men are women. That's why nation is pushing America back to America. We are sending it down out there to fight war. He's coming back again. Because he cannot handle it as a man. Because America's power is abomination. What happened to America? Where did you lose your God? Why did America change his God to hold on to God? America changed his God to a combination. God is trying to hold on to humanity. Sodom and Sister Gomorrah. God is trying to hold on to humanity. For man having sex with man. And woman laying dead with woman. And human learning animals. You are learning animals. You are learning a dog. You are learning a donkey. You are learning a horse. God is a domination. God is the God in the world. You are like a man. God has to change. That's why God has to let the children. Let the children be. He's the man. But I said, God, you can destroy me and drop me in. God is telling me to go, change America. Change your population plan. Change your homosexual life. Change your money life. When you send your child to school, when you're a politician, in this country, now you're going to be kidnapping your child and putting your little babies in prostitution. Yes! America's sick! America's sick! When you love a young girl, go to the pool, and she opened her mouth, she said, let you make blood, you bitch! Where you hear us? Where did you hear us? Where did you call her? And where are America? God is telling America to change. Change before it's too late. America was a nation under one God. But today, America is no longer a nation. America is no longer a nation. America is a city. America, God on the street, God put America in a palace. But America ends up on the street because it was not believing God. God is calling America to change today. Every one of you must take your part in change. Every one of you mothers and brothers and sisters and brothers must take a part in change
to give America back to God. God is calling America back home. Are you going to give America today? People, mothers and fathers, are you going to come out of that life you're living? That's a false power of life. One man has killed woman. Yes! One man has killed woman. Yes! Yes! Politicians are getting rampant. A young girl thinks now why she doesn't have to marry and settle and live a nice life with her husband. See, you know, sin. This world has so much of sin. Sinful world. But God still loves the world. He's calling to give a second chance. Anybody want to give a second chance? Want a second chance today? God is calling American people to come back to Him. God is willing to give America. We can see how much destruction America is going through right now. That's only with smoke. Because when the fire comes and God burns on America, there will be no place to run and no place to hide. Because God says, I give you a second chance and you did not take it, America. Let it just go. Amen. Let it just go. Amen. Let it just go. And those who have heard, let them hear. The word of the Lord.
Wow, how is it that everybody on how is it that every time you get on a mic? The last sermon is better than the first. Woo! Look like I got some competition up in here. You know, scripture says, no one is worthy. No, not one. No one is worthy. We are all as filthy rags. I didn't say that. My sister in Christ didn't say that. God said it. He said, we are all as filthy rags. But it's begotten and son on the cross shed his blood for us so that we can become worthy. So that we can become worthy. But America has turned their back to God and said, I want to do things my way. You can't do things your way, America. It's got to be your way. It's got to be your way, God's way, or no way at all. And that's where the war is heading right now. It's going nowhere at all. Really fast. Yes, like it says, I will make the land desolate. We will be going nowhere very, very fast. Amen. We have nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. We can't hide from God. It's like Adam was hiding from God after the day sin. Adam was hiding from God. And he put a wreath around his waist to hide from God. And God said, Adam, where are you? But he already knew where Adam was. But he was hiding. And God said, why are you hiding? Why are you wearing that wreath around you? And Adam said, Lord, because I am naked. And God said, who told you that you was naked? God knows everything, sees everything, and he knows your final destination. God has a plan for everybody under my voice. The only thing I can tell you is, if you're walking in the light, if you accept Jesus, God's plan for you is to fulfill His will for your life. But if you're walking in darkness and you reject Jesus, then God's plan for you is condemnation and being sent to the lake of fire. Because you see, when you reject Jesus, you reject your salvation. When you reject Jesus, you reject your own life. When you reject Jesus, you reject your freedom. Because the king is all of that and then stop. It gives us all of that and then stop. God said, harden not your heart. And I will give you a heart of flesh. You will no longer have a heart of stone. And you will come to fully understand me and walk in my way. Never been disobedient to God, just like the Israelites were disobedient to God for 400 years. He waited for them. Who has that kind of patience right now in this world? Nobody. None of us can even live for 400 years, let alone have patience. Some of us can have patience for one day. None of us are holding grudges against our brother, against our sister, against our mother, against our father. The Lord said, forgive those, and I will forgive you. How can you expect the Lord to forgive you if you are holding your grudge? If you can't forgive your brother or your sister, the Lord is not going to forgive you. Amen. Just like my sister in Christ said, America used to be a Christian nation. America used to be favored, highly favored and blessed by God. But America has turned their back to the Lord. America wants to do things their way. You can't do it your way. Amen. My way is not going to get me to heaven. Your way is not going to get me to heaven. My pastor can't get me to heaven. My congregation is not going to get me to heaven. I can go to church every Sunday. That doesn't mean I'm saved. I'm not going to heaven just by going to church. Church is not for salvation. Let's get this straight right now. Church is not for salvation. You can go on YouTube and have online church every day.
You sound good.
But a lot of people go to church and they still don't know Jesus. A lot of people go to church and they still and they still sin. Because the church is telling them things that they want to hear. I call it ear candy. And there's the economy. That's not the gospel. That's the ear candy gospel. We're telling you the real gospel. This is the gospel that helps you to get saved. You might not like it, but it's the gospel. It's not ear candy. Because if I give you the ear candy gospel, you're not going to know Jesus. You're going to be condemned. This is the help you to get saved gospel. Amen.
We don't care if you like it or not.
Amen.
We don't care.
Our job is to spread the gospel and to tell you the truth of Jesus and what you must do to come to the kingdom of God to be saved. You might not like it, but it's worth it. You might not like it, but it's worth it.